Hello and welcome to this PL-300 Power BI exam preparation training. I'd first of all just like to introduce myself. My name's Matt Allington. I've been working in Power BI for a very long time now, at the time of recording about 10 years. I've actually got more than 30 years experience working in sales and customer service. I've also spent quite a bit of time working in IT and have got a very unique view on how IT and business work together in order to be able to deliver value for business. I've run this Power BI consultancy in Sydney for, as I said, about 10 years. So I offer self-service BI consulting. I also offer live and online training. You're looking at one of the online training courses now. And I do have a blog with lots of content that you can look at if you're interested in that. This is my book, Supercharge Power BI. I first wrote this book in 2015. And there's four different versions of the book, five if you count the Korean version. And so if you're interested in learning in depth about DAX, then that's a great book. I'm also a Microsoft Power BI MVP. Now, let me talk about the audience profile for this PL-300 exam. So the exam is designed for business professionals that use data. So this is not a deeply technical exam. The exam is designed to identify people that have the skills to be a data analyst using the Power BI suite of tools. This has come from the official Microsoft website. So pause the video and read the details if you like. But the bottom line is, this is for business users. And so if that's you, then you're in the right place. Okay, I want to explain clearly what you should expect from this training course. So my objective is to review the breadth of topics that are covered in the PL-300 exam. So this is an exam preparation course. We're going to dive into selected areas to build your breadth of understanding, and it will also help flush out areas where you have gaps in understanding. And you'll learn about the format of the exam and tips for answering questions in the exam. I would generally expect that you have a minimum of 12 months experience across the entire product range of Power BI. So this course is not going to teach you Power BI. If you've come to this course for the purpose of learning Power BI, then you are in the wrong place. This course is an exam preparation course, which will help you cover the breadth of topics so that you know what you know and you know what you don't know. It will give you some direction to help you understand what you don't know, and then you may need to go and do some further learning before you sit the exam. I also like to point out at this stage that the exam, the PL-300 exam, is not an open book exam. So what you should understand is that when you sit the exam, it's going to be rigorously invigilated by a proctor, assuming that you do this exam at home. Someone is going to be using your webcam to watch you during the time that you answer the questions in the exam. You're not going to be able to use Google to find the answers. And so this is totally on recall and memory and experience. And once again, this is why this course is important, because it makes sure that you understand what you know and what you don't know prior to sitting that exam. All the slides that you see in all of the videos in this course are available for download. They're printed as handouts. I think it's 3 slides per page. So I recommend that you use these slides to record your progress. So if you have a topic area that you're perhaps a little bit weaker on, then make a note in your handout so that you know and you can come back and review that later. Now, there's a couple of ways you can do that. You can either print out the handouts, or you could use Adobe Acrobat if you like and just make notes in there. But it's a great way to keep track of the areas that you need to come back and refocus on. Now, in order to get the most out of this training, I recommend you take the following approach. So generally speaking, don't try and follow along with me on the screen. I'm going to be doing a lot of demos, so it's much better to focus and listen to what I'm saying and then take the notes on the slide deck, as I mentioned, so that you can come back and brush up and review later. Also, within the structure of the Skillwave Training course outline, you can mark the lessons as completed or not. So I recommend that if there's a topic that you want to come back and review, then do not mark it as completed. Only mark the lessons that you feel comfortable with as completed, and then that way you can come back and review the other videos later. You can complete the demos if you wish, but I suggest you wait until you've watched the full demo first and then try and do it yourself. By forcing yourself to try and follow through the demo yourself, it will help you reinforce the learning and help you clarify where you've got gaps. All the sample files that are in the demos are provided as part of the course materials. You will, or you certainly should, know most things already. So if there's a lot of gaps in your knowledge, then maybe you're not ready for the PL-300 exam. This is a chance for you to confirm what you do know and also identify what you don't know and potentially fill some gaps, but you may need to go and do some more learning in order to be able to be prepared for the actual PL-300 exam.